What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today is a good day because today is finally the day that we are able to drive the all-new Porsche 911 992 GT3. It's the car we're all waiting for, basically. Every time Porsche announces a new 911, we think, yeah, that's nice, Carrera S cool, GTS cool, Turbo S cool, but the one you are waiting for is the GT3, and of course the GT3 RS, but the GT3 is always, I think, is always the coolest in the range, because it's the car that has been developed for track and road use, and I really like that. I like that better than the purely track-focused GT3 RS, which is awesome if you have the ability and resources to track your GT3 RS. I mean, that must be super expensive, but the GT3 is the best of both worlds, if you ask me, and that's why I love it so much. It also feels like a race car every time you get in it. It doesn't really matter if you're going 30 kilometers an hour or 300. It always feels special. And today I'm going to review it. I'm going to show you around it. I'll show you a couple of the cool things, and then we'll take it for a drive towards the Autobahn, where it should be nice and empty for an Autobahn blast. It is 8:45 right now in the evening, so that should be all right. But before we begin, let me take a moment to thank today's sponsor, which is Y-Food, a very healthy and nutritious meal replacement shake. For us, we're a lot on the move, we're a lot on the road. We are always struggling to find something healthy to eat. The options are a gas station, which is basically French fries and a sausage, or fast food, which is not great. If you do that a lot, that's not very healthy. So this is a really good alternative because it's not a protein shake or a diet drink, it's a real meal replacement. You should drink this when you're hungry. Because we teamed up with Y-Food, of course you get a discount. Check out the code right there, or go to the links in the description or the pinned comment. And most importantly, of course, it tastes really good, but it also contains 26 minerals and vitamins. It's lactose-free, gluten-free, has a shelf life of over 6 months. You don't need to refrigerate it, and we've got a lot of other tastes. So this is crazy coconut, which I really like, but this is the taster pack, which contains a couple of other flavors as well. Now, they also offer a bar as a healthy snack and a powder, which of course is very convenient to take with you anywhere. So if you're interested, go check them out. Links are in the description, discount code, everything you need to set yourself up. Okay, so where to begin? That's always the thing with these cars. There's so much new and cool stuff on it that I struggle to find a starting point. But let's start at the front, like we always do. And we'll start at the nose, because I kind of still have to get used to two things. The nose, the weird like nostrils, almost like Angry Bird nostrils at the front, with that roundness, and the massive swan neck rear wing, which we'll get to later. Oh, we've also got this matched key, which I wanted to show you. That looks really cool, right? This is shark blue. Not sure about the color. I think it does fit the GT3 very well, but the problem is that all of them are in this color. So I've seen it like 20 times already. Anyway, front nostrils, a lot of heat comes out from here because there's a radiator down there, and I guess, you know, as long as it's super functional, I don't mind, but I'm not sure it's very pretty. But anyway, we've got a very, well, it doesn't really look like a regular 911 anymore. We've got this super racy front bumper with this massive gaping hole that looks absolutely awesome. Well, as you can see, a lot of bugs have died in the making of this video. Well, the Autobahn POV, really. So it's Martijn's fault, not mine. Yeah, it's basically a very big blue fly swatter, or mosquito swatter, this car. We've got this lower part here in this black plastic, which makes it look like a race car, which is very cool. I think that the splitter is manually adjustable, this lower part here. I read that somewhere, but I can't see how. Apparently it is. And we've got a intake here, or a duct for a radiator in there, and there's nothing in there, but it is open, so that's good. We've got the black headlights as well, with a little blue line in there. That is very cool. Yeah, it's a cool car. It really looks like a race car. So the wheels, we've got 20-inch wheels at the front, 21s at the rear, and a beautiful lightweight wheel. Although they are heavier than the wheels on the previous generation, the car in general is wider, it's bigger, it's heavier. Like, there are heavier components on it, but still it's only 5 kilos heavier than the previous one. And they've done that by doing some lightweight stuff around the car. The bonnet, for instance, I'll show you that in a minute. It's got lighter gloss, it's got a very light exhaust system that saves 10 kilos. So there's a lot of stuff that's heavier and a lot of stuff that's lighter, and that's why it's almost the same weight. We don't have carbon ceramics on this car, which I believe is a mistake by someone at Porsche in the Netherlands. That was not supposed to happen. And it is a mistake because the brakes are not great. They wear out quite quickly if you drive it hard a lot, which these press cars get driven quite hard. So carbon ceramics, always do that. Always, always, always better. And we've got these center lock wheels, of course, which are just gorgeous, and I want to eat them up. We've got Goodyear Eagle F1 Super Sport R tires. Is that the name?
That's a very long name.
Yeah, that's it. Eagle F1 Super Sport R. Quite sticky, as you can see. It's basically a cup 2 tire, I think. We also have double wishbone suspension at the front for the first time on a road going 911. So instead of the regular McPherson struts, we've got double wishbones, which came from the Porsche 911 RSR racing car, which is a really big deal on this car. And while I'm here, I also wanted to show you guys, I don't know if I can actually get this low, but we're going to try. You have to get underneath here. I saw this in the Chris Harris video. He put it up on like a lift. There are these little canards, winglets, on the bottom of the car. The entire bottom of the car is flat. And there are these ducts that guide the air. You can see it. Maybe you can see it at the front there, behind the front wheel. Oh my God. Okay. So I hope you guys could see that. But that looks super cool. The rear suspension has been changed as well to be able to like talk with the front suspension, basically. So it makes sense with the new multi-link at the front. And at the rear, well, okay, let's just address the elephant in the room. Apart from the fact that this car also doesn't have the optional carbon fiber roof, which would be cool, is this wing, okay? It's here. So if you're in a race and you're in the pits and the jacks don't work anymore, you can just lift the car up and change the rear tires. No, I'm not that strong. No, so this is a swan neck design, and it means that you can see that the spoiler is mounted on top instead of underneath. And this optimizes the airflow underneath here with this built-in ducktail, which is also super awesome. And the fact that this has been designed this way means that the angle of the spoiler is less aggressive, which means that you don't sacrifice as much top speed as you would with a regularly mounted spoiler wing. So this car actually generates 50% more downforce than the GT3 of the previous generation. It develops as much downforce as the previous generation GT3 RS, and you can actually adjust this, as you can see, so you can make it even more aggressive if you go to like the Nürburgring, and that would give you 50% more downforce than the GT3 RS of the previous generation. So there's a lot of downforce, let's just say it as it is. I don't know about the wing. I think it is a GT3 RS wing, right? I think it's a lot of aggressive race car aero for a GT3. I mean, what are they going to do with the GT3 RS? Is that just going to have like a wing that's this high and has like 10 winglets on it? I mean, where do you go from here? But I guess it does look cool. I mean, it's a very cool rear end. And I especially love this ducktail. I mean, there's a guy near our office and he's driving a GT3 RS, previous generation, and he's running it without the rear wing. And you just have that ducktail and it just looks so awesome. I think this car without the rear wing would be epic, absolutely epic. Because the GT3 Touring, which is also coming, as you know, without the spoilers and stuff, also doesn't have the ducktail, so it has a regular rear end. So I think this without the spoiler would be just sick. What else? We've got the diffuser, as you can see, which is very cool. This space between the bumper and the diffuser, I always really like that. You see that with McLarens as well. The diffuser is also derived from the RSR race car, as well as the spoiler and, as I said, the multi-link suspension. Now, the engine is right here. Now, I can't show you guys, I can't open it up. You can only open up this one for the oil. But we've got the 4 liter, as you can see, flat six in there. Single mass flywheel, still 9,000 RPM, and it delivers 510 horsepower and 470 newton meters of torque, which is 10 up for both in comparison to the previous GT3. So I think this basically is the perfect setup. So you don't want anything more. You don't want to extract more from this crazy high revving engine. This is it. You don't need any more power than this. So just stop here and we will all be happy. Okay, we're going to open the frunk. And wow, it's really light. I think it saves like 2.5 kilos. And you can see that this is carbon fiber reinforced plastic. Looks awesome. Little trunk space here still. But man, yeah, it's the car to end all cars. I don't know what to say about this car anymore. It just gets better and better. And every time you drive one, you think, well, it can't get any better than this. And then it does. Okay. So, interior, not going to cover that a lot. We've got Alcantara leather with blue stitching and we've got a roll cage in the rear. You can't get rear seats in the GT3. We have the optional carbon fiber buckets, which, you know, the seating position is 10 out of 10. Absolutely spot on, perfect, but they are quite uncomfortable. So for longer journeys, not great. For hooning it around a track or a B road, absolutely perfect. And what else? Well, we've got a very important thing here. This is a regular gear lever, as you can see. We don't have that stupid miniature gear lever you get in the regular 992s. You get a proper gear lever. And so you operate it as you would, like that. It's very short, very nice. If you put it in manual mode, down is a gear up. And oh, that is just the most perfect shift of an automatic gear lever ever. It's just heaven. Okay, so neutral. That's valve closed. Oh, we've got shark blue seat belts as well. And well, we're in track mode right now, which turns off the screens on the right. I'll show you guys, this is normal. So we've got 5 screens basically. And if we go to track mode, you can see that you get a simplified, darker version of the info. Okay, so manual mode. And we've got shift lights on both sides of the rev counter as well, which is just perfect. Oh, so there are horses around here on the left, so we're going to go right here. Yeah, I don't know what to add to this sound. I know that some of you are complaining in my reviews that I talk too much, but I think, well, don't watch the review, just watch the POV video. And in this case, I would definitely recommend watching the POV video and the Autobahn POV. For this insane sound. There's just nothing that compares to driving a GT3 or a GT3 RS. 9,000 RPM is crazy, but it's all the time. It's also 6 or 5,000 RPM. It's just crazy all the time. So, 0 to 100, 3.4 seconds, which is ridiculously quick. And I'm in track mode right now. And the thing is just so supple and so comfy while still being super direct and super hardcore. It's just a really weird combination. Okay, so I'm going to show you guys a trick. Okay, so in neutral we have a soft limiter, 4000 rpm, but if you put it in drive, pull both pedals and then rev it, you can go to 7. I mean, that's a really good sound. Oh my goodness. That is just ridiculous. That's insane. I mean, it just feels and sounds like the engine is going to explode in here when you hit that 9000 RPM. But at the same time, it runs so smoothly and so balanced that it just works so well. Oh, we have to do a launch control. Okay, we're going to do that here. No one behind me. Full throttle. Seconds to 100. That is really quick. Okay, so at the Autobahn, we're going to keep it in track mode and we're going to see if that works. I think that works. ridiculous. This car is ridiculous. That's the only word I have for it. The brake pedal is quite firm, and you feel like there's not really that much braking performance, but there really is. It does brake quite well, but you just feel like it's not great. Yeah, that's what I meant when I said it's ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. It is such a freaking beast. It revs out. It delivers on all fronts. It is one of the most enjoyable car experiences out there, honestly. And of course, we also measured the 100 to 200 kilometer an hour run, which was 7.46, which is also quite quick. It's actually 2/10 quicker than the previous generation GT3 RS, so it definitely delivers on that front. So that's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. You can subscribe by clicking the big button in the middle. You can also check out this video or go check out this playlist. See you at the next one. Bye, guys.